What's going on, dudes? My name is Prestige. Today is a huge day for any fan of OpTic Gaming out there, or even fans of esports. Sledgehammer Games announced that there's going to be an OpTic Gold gear set coming to Call of Duty Advanced Warfare on August 10th, first on Xbox, and then later down the line for PlayStation as well. This is great. I mean, this is interesting, not only for OpTic Gaming, so congratulations to OpTic Hex and everyone in that organization, but it's great for esports, and I'll talk about why. Now, you have to realize this is the second gear set coming to Call of Duty Advanced Warfare that's related to an esports team. The first one was for Denial Esports because they won the World Champs. They won the Call of Duty Championship. Now, the second one, OpTic Gold, is actually coming from the X Games win in Austin when they won gold there. So, you have to remember that both of these teams, both of these organizations have started basically where you would have started your YouTube channel. So just think of it this way. You're just sitting there thinking of an idea like, hey, you know what? How about we start a team? And it's just a group of buddies that started something, in this case, OpTic Hex and I believe his brother. You know, they started OpTic Gaming and then they never imagined it would turn into something like this. And that's an incredible feeling to build something from the base level into something so extraordinary. And to be able to see your creation, your work inside of a Call of Duty game, that would feel nothing but great. That would be great because that is your core audience. That is where you are going to be playing. That is where you get your victories. That is where you started your team. That is where all your growth started. That's like me saying, guys, there's going to be a PrestigeisKey loadout coming to Advanced Warfare. You know how excited I would be? That would be just remarkably awesome. I would absolutely love to do something like that, but this is probably just the greatest feeling in the world for OpTic Hex, and this is probably the greatest feeling for not only them, but Denial Esports as well. After winning COD Champs, being able to take home that $400,000 check, and plus have their gear forever immortalized in a video game, that's something that anybody could want. So not only is this good for esports as an organization, because people are going to start getting this gear, and if they aren't familiar with the emblem, or if they aren't familiar with OpTic Gaming or Denial Esports, they'll start researching it, and esports will grow a little bit more. They'll be able to check it out and go more in depth and see what's going on and try to get a hang of it and say, hey, you know, maybe I want to start my own team, or hey, you know, I'm going to keep supporting this specific team, or this is my new favorite team, and just keep going from there. So the growth is going to expand it from this just a simple gear set. And I know that that might sound crazy, but it's great. It's a great feeling for me too, because now that I think of it this way, it almost seems like Activision is opening up a little bit more to the idea of introducing exclusive sets, or, you know, exclusive gear and in-game camouflages and stuff like that for things that we enjoy in the real world. You know, they see a beneficial thing from it. And I've actually noticed a lot of you guys saying, well, where's the favorite team that I enjoy? You know, where's FaZe gear? Where's the Lightning Pandas? Where's this? Where's that? And I think it would be great if they would take all of these teams, work together with their legal departments or whatever, get the branding icons and make them into their own gear sets, but put them together in a pack. Call it the esports pack or the esports, you know, DLC pack or something, where you can just download every single outfit of your favorite esports team and you can wear it whenever you want. I don't really, like I said once again, I don't really like the fact that you have to find each and every piece in a supply drop, but I guess that's just how it goes. I mean, it's one of those things where I really like supply drops, okay? And I really like the idea behind it, and I want to make a video talking about supply drops for possibly Advanced Warfare 2, which we will do very, very soon, but I think that if it comes down to DLC, like a specific gear set, sure, have maybe three or four different gear sets available for the advanced supply drops, but make them super rare. But if there's something like the Denial Esports gear or the OpTic Gaming gear, make it so it's $1.99. You know, the same thing could be said for like the Whiteout gear. The same thing could be said for the Biohazard gear. If all of that was $1.99, I would rather spend the $1.99, get my gear that I want, instead of rolling the dice and possibly not getting anything at all. So let me know what you guys think down below in the comments section. I think that this is a great forward push for esports. Like I said before, I am not a fan of playing that hard. I like to watch esports. I like to hear the teams communicate with each other. But as for playing that hard, I'm more of just a casual player, and that's just how I am. So thank you guys so much for watching today's video. If you enjoyed, make sure to click the thumbs up button down below, and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace.